I will show you two ways on how to obtain the Power BI download, install it, and get started in only minutes. There are two ways to download Power BI. You can do it through the Microsoft website or the Microsoft Store, and I'm going to tell you which one is much, much easier. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Joe Zeplin, Microsoft MVP and small business coach based here in Florida. In this video, we're going to discuss Power BI, how to get started, and the first steps you should take to better your business, better your life, or just make yourself more efficient. If you started researching Power BI, you probably noticed there's a lot out there, and it can be kind of overwhelming when you're first getting started. I'm going to show you that the key to success in Power BI is in one very simple, easy tool. Power BI Desktop, and that's going to be the tool that we're installing today. There are two ways to download Power BI Desktop. First, you can do so through Microsoft's website. The link is down in the description, or you can simply search Power BI download and select this link here. Once on the page, select the Try for Free button on the top right of your screen. Lastly, add your work email and you are now ready to download. Note, if you do not have a work email or you like to download Power BI in your personal email, download option number two is going to be much easier and honestly your best choice. The second method to downloading Power BI is doing so right on the Microsoft Store on your computer. To do this, select the Start button in the bottom of your screen and search Microsoft Store. Once open, simply search Power BI Desktop in the search bar and then download the application. When the application is finished downloading, you'll be able to open it by selecting the Windows button again, but this time searching Power BI. When you first open Power BI, you'll be granted with this screen welcoming you to the application. On the right side, it includes some links on news, blogs, forums, and the tutorials are great. This is gonna be the first of several tutorials in our Power BI playlist here on this channel, so I encourage you to check those out, and if you have additional information, there's plenty of good information in these tutorials right here. And on the left side, it gives you some shortcuts on creating your first Power BI dashboard. Before we input any data, I created some fake data for you and I to walk through together. It's fairly simple, and the link is here in the description below. As you can see, it's very simple data. On the left side, you're going to see 50 lines of different cookie sales, with each sale including a little bit of information on the sales rep who sold the cookies, the state in which they sold them, whether they sold cookies or special dessert ice cream or even pizza, the quantity they sold, revenue per unit, cost per unit, profit per unit, total revenue, total cost, and total profit. Very straightforward information. In our dashboard, we're going to be answering three simple questions. How much of each type of product did we sell? How much revenue did each sales rep bring into the company? And then if we were going to divide our sales reps into a region, which sales rep would it make sense to have where and why? Back in Power BI Desktop, we're going to select Get Data on the left side. You'll then be given the option of which type of data source you would like to include. As you can see, you can import from Excel, from a text notepad, you can import an entire folder. In this tutorial here, we're going to do the Excel workbook and press Connect. Then simply go to where you saved Joe's cookie sales, click that file, and select Open. As you can see, the file is Joe's Cookie Sales, and right beneath it, you're going to see the table that we want to select and bring into Power BI. So that's going to be the sales table. You'll see a little preview on the right side of the different columns in the sales table. At the bottom, you have the option to load and transform the data. If you load the data, you're going to take the data as is, not making any changes to it. I always recommend choosing Transform Data so you can do what you like. So you just open up the Power BI Query Editor. If you look at it, I know it can seem a little overwhelming. We'll go through it step by step. It's very simple once you get the hang of it. In the middle are all the columns from the Excel file we just imported. On the right side are the changes you want to make to those Excel columns. If you look, let's consider sales rep. We have Don, Emily, Matthew, and Sarah. If we wanted to exclude Matthew from our data set, we just toggle Matthew off, click OK. He'll no longer be in our visuals. And if you look to the right, it said that we filtered Matthew out. If you want to redo this step, simply click the X and Matthew's now back in the data. You'll also notice there have already been some applied steps. This is Power BI making your life a little bit easier. All it does is take the source, promote headers, changing the formatting, like sales rep is most likely a name, where quantity is going to be a number, and that's all it did. If you see any of those are incorrect, you simply select these boxes here and you can choose what type of formatting you like it to be. For today's video, let's go ahead and click close and apply. It's going to take our data and load it into Power BI Desktop. Now this is your Power BI canvas. So the canvas is this dotted line square here, and that's everything that's going to show in your report once you share it with others. The things on the right are only for you to see in designing your report. If we start on the right side, fields is the Excel file that we saved earlier. And if you look, these are all of your columns. In the middle here are different visuals you can choose from. And if you want to take a look at your data again in the table view, there's actually a table over here for you to do just that. So let's think back to our three questions. We want to see how much of each product we sold. So what we can do is select a table. Let's click product and quantity. And on the left, just like that, you'll see that we sold 100 cookies, 68 ice cream, and 87 pizzas. If you'd like to look at this in a different format, simply click the table and choose the visual in the visualization pane that you want to see. If you want to see a bar chart, you can choose the pie chart, line chart. That doesn't look too good. Let's stick with the table. The second question we wanted to answer is how much revenue each sales rep was bringing in. What we're going to do on that one is we'll click sales rep, total revenue, and product. Of course, you put in a table, but if you'd like to see them side by side, I always like this clustered column chart right here, and it's going to show us that Matthew is doing great. Good thing we didn't exclude him from the data. He's selling all the pizza. He's got some good ice cream in there. Could get his cookie sales up a little bit. If you look at Devon, he's doing great on cookies, but not so good on ice cream. It gives you the breakdown of each person fairly quickly. Lastly, the third question we want to answer is what would happen if we broke each sales rep into a region? So who's selling the most in which states? One of my favorite tools in Power BI are these little maps here. The one on the left is named map. It looks like a globe. That's more for roads and zip codes. And the one on the right is more for states. So let's look at the whole map. We're going to select state. We're going to select sales rep. And for bubble size, let's select total revenue. And if you look at each of these states, it's going to show you, okay, most of our sales are in Florida, where we only have a small amount, and Texas and Kansas. And if we look specifically in Florida, our sales are coming from mostly Matthew, then Devon, then Sarah, then Emily. This can be very helpful information for you to get fairly quickly, and you can use it for states, zip codes, countries, whatever you like. The last thing I want to show you is how to filter your data even a little more. On the right side, there's this little visual that looks like a weird broken Rubik's Cube. It's called a tree map. And once you click it, let's go on the right and choose any two fields. So let's choose product and total revenue. On here, it's going to break up that pizza is the product that we make the most revenue on, followed by cookies, then ice cream. And if you click pizza, the rest of the data will filter to show you only pizza information. And this also works with any other visual you have available. Let's say we only wanted to look at Emily's sales. Click Emily, and the rest of the visuals change accordingly. Lastly, if you want to make your report look a little bit more visually appealing, go ahead and navigate to the View tab, and they have all these cool designs for you to choose from. Let's choose this one. And just like that, you created your very first Power BI report. Now you should share it with others. So on the left side, if you go to File, first thing you're going to want to do is Save. Once it's saved, go back to File and press Publish. Here you'll be able to publish to Power BI. When you publish to Power BI, it's going to create a URL, and you can send to anyone you'd like to see your report. Great job, you just created your first dashboard in only a couple of minutes. If you enjoyed this video, this is the first of numerous videos in our Power BI playlist, where you go from never opening the tool to being an expert 1 minute at a time. I highly recommend you check it out. Go to the next one, it's really good. As a friendly reminder, I do go live pretty often to answer your Power BI questions, so subscribe and hit the notification bell. The second I go live, you'll get a text that I'm here. Let me help you. Welcome to the Startup Squad. And of course, as all things small business, start small, start today. We'll see you soon.